Everybody, today I'm going to be teaching you how to do a GFX in Roblox. So what you're first going to do is you're going to go to Roblox Studio and you're going to go to, View, and you're going to click Show Grid, and this is where you want to put your character, because if you put it over here, or over there, instead of being right in the center, it'll be all over there. So, what I like to use is this plugin, this load character. Just use me. Rotate it. And move it so at least it's right here. And if you get mad at these little green things, I hate them, you just click Show Details and they're gone. Oh yeah, and when you move, I would recommend to rotate 5 and then to move 0.05 studs when you're moving this and stuff. And so, yeah, I'm going to rotate some of the arms. Just going to open up your character in Explorer and find what you want to move. And it will do that. I'm new to doing this, so sorry if this is not what you expected. So, yeah. Sorry, it's in the morning and yeah. So I guess I'm just going to go like this and move it up and over and down, over. Oh. I'm so sorry. One last thing is collisions. You right here. Look, if you click it, it's gonna not let you move the stuff. So you're gonna unclick it, so you can move it freely however you want. And I'm gonna have my character just look like she's dancing. And one last thing that I can show you to do is you can add all kinds of stuff, like if you wanted, say, a motorcycle, what you're going to do is you're going to just rotate however you want, and when you get the motorcycle, whenever you add another thing, you're going to want to add it into one folder. So I'm just going to add it into my character, so now it's in here, and you can open and see all the properties and all the stuff. So yeah, I want to save this now, so you're probably asking, how do I save it? Well, what you do is you right click, and you click Export Selection. I'm just gonna make a new folder, and it's going to be called YouTube Vid Tutorial. For GFX. Now you're just gonna open it, and I'm just gonna say part 1, first part. You can name it whatever you want. I'm really bad at naming stuff, but you just gotta save it to where you can remember it. And you're gonna wanna leave this open just in case it doesn't save or anything. You're just gonna wanna leave it open. Nope, not that yet. Sorry. Now you go to, when you get on here, you're gonna right click on the block and you're gonna click delete on your keyboard and then click delete with your mouse. And for the lighting, you just click delete and delete. and I'll show you how to get lighting again later on. And when you think you're like, oh, I want to do if you can't, you try all kinds of stuff, you're like using your arrow keys, nothing works. You click Shift F and you can move. So Shift F makes you move, and then when you left click, boom, it stops and you can just position it wherever you want. Now you're gonna click file, and then click import wavefront OBJ, and you're gonna go to where you saved it, and I saved in there, and you're gonna click the OBJ, not the MTL. Now you're gonna go to right here, and you're gonna click texture. Now as you see this right here, it's like, what the heck is happening? It's not textured. Well, trust me, it will look like that if you save it into multiple files, but it'll look better once we do the ending. Now, I'm not that good at bending limbs, so I'm not gonna do that today. I'm gonna try to learn how to do that later. Oh yeah, and if you really wanna know where I learned how to do GFX, this is also on a video. It was from, I think, Foods, and you should go watch her video too. It's amazing. And now I'm just going, when you want to position your camera, because if I go into my camera right now, you have to right click, oops, oh. But you have to left click on the camera. Well, you have to left click and then you have to right click, so you go like this. And then you left click to stop it and right click to go like that. Then you click 0 and you click Shift F, and then you can move your camera into the position you want. So I think I'm just gonna kind of zoom out a little bit, and you left click, boom. If you want to get out, you click 0 again and then Shift F to move. Now you probably want lighting on your character, because if you go into render, click render image, it's pitch black. So you're gonna go back down to here and click 3D view, and you're going to click shading for one. This is not gonna give you lighting, but this is so we can add a background later on. Then you're gonna click to this globe and just click that, that, and that. Now click render image, and boom, you got your GFX right there. Now if you want to save it, so you can go to here and add a background, you click image, save as image, and you put it, I put it mine in the folder that I had it in. This is going to be finished. I don't care about spelling finished. However, that it's not spelled right, but I know, don't be mad at me. Finished. Yeah. You just name it however you want. I name it as weird stuff. It's however you want. Now you go to here, and you'll go to right here. And you go to where you saved it, and I save mine in here. Stupid. Yeah. Why does this do this to me? Oh, wait. Did I not save it in the right one? Oh, I saved it in the wrong one. Okay, I'm really stupid. Sorry, yes, I saved it in the wrong one. So now you're gonna add a background, which is just down here. And add new layer, and you're gonna go under, so it will be behind your character instead of in front. Now you can do it like, sometimes I like to just make grass, but if you don't want to do that, you can if you don't want to, you can go to Google. Why is my stupid Google being stupid? And let's see what kind of background. about chibi background. So now you can find little cute little chibi things. And let's see which ones I would like. How about this one's really cute. I like this one. So you click copy image. And you click Control V. And you can always click keep canvas size. And see, now it's behind the people, because if I put it in front, you won't be able to see us. So you gotta, boom. And now it looks like they're in Ice Cream Land. And for the last part, you're going to go either to File and Save As, or you can just go to right here and save. You'll go to 3D Objects, and in the tutorial, and I'll click Finished for Reels. And still, I spelled things wrong. I know how to spell words, just don't question it. Now, if you go to here, you can go 3D Objects. And boom. You got it saved, and it'll probably add it on here. And you can do whatever you want. I have my phone with me. I'm probably just going to take a picture real quick on my phone. It's going to be uploaded to my Insta, because Instagram's life. No, I don't want the flash on. My flash. Okay, and yeah, that's pretty much it. If you want to just go follow me on Instagram, then go do that. I would. My Instagram name is Gabriel.Lindsay07. And I post my GFXs there. I have just one little folder. It's like a ton of pictures, and you can just scroll through. There's three on there right now, but that's not all I have. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And I think I'll see you. Oh, sorry. I'll see you guys later. So have a good day. And bye.